going to install a PCI card.
Firewire.
Specifically, a 4-port PCI 1394A Firewire card with video editing kit. This came from StarTech.com. I actually ordered it off Amazon.com. Now, what's in a video editing kit? Well, first of all, it comes with this here. You need video editing software. I already have my video editing software, so I didn't really need that. So why'd I buy the kit? Because it also came with the wire that I need. See, my old computer crashed, and it had this mini DV connection on the computer. My new computer don't have that, so I had to order something so I could transfer videos again. Firewire seems to be a popular option because I see a lot of these from mini DV to Firewire. Now, it's out of focus, and I'm not going to bother trying to focus. Just look up on the internet Firewire and mini DV, and you can figure out what they look like. It looks similar to USB, but it ain't USB. And there's your PCI card. It's got three slots in the back. There's also an internal one. There it is. So Firewire's used to connect other devices besides cameras. So I can connect other things to it. So it's a little bit more versatile, a little more useful. Yes, it is. Now don't take my word for it, but from what I've read, you can connect 64-bit computers to 32-bit PCI cards, and you can connect 32-bit computers to 64-bit PCI cards. The problem is you'll just be limited to the lowest performing component is what will happen. So keep that in mind. And don't take my word for it. I don't install these things every day. This is what worked for me today. So let's get started. What you want to do is caress your computer. Now some people use anti-static mats. I ain't got one. So if you touch the metal case of your computer, it helps to make sure you don't get any static discharge, which can really damage your components. Yes, this is a Dell. Dude, you're getting a Dell. The thing I like about this one, look there. Just pull the thing on the back and it pops right off, pops right off, it pops right off, it pops right off. Let me show you what this looks like inside. Now here's the inside of my computer case here. Let's zoom in a little bit. Yep, there you go. Here's PCI. It's kind of dark ones, PCI. There's PCI Express, there's different kinds of PCI cards, which is, from what I've read again, is weird. Even if the size of the slot differs from the size of the pins on the card, it will still work. For example, this is a Firewire 400 PCI card. I could have got a Firewire 800 and it would have fit in this slot right here, except it would have actually been smaller. It wouldn't take up the whole space of the slot, but you could still stick it in there and it would still work. Seems like PCI is pretty versatile, but gosh, you can stick any PCI card in any PCI slot. It looks like you can catch some kind of PCI disease or something. I don't know.
It pops right off.
PCI is going everywhere. Anyway, you see the gap there, and you see the gap right here. This looks like it should fit perfectly. Now, yeah, I could have went with a PCI 800 and maybe transferred video at twice the rate, 800 megabits per second. But I know on my camera, I have a memory card for taking photographs, and it has an 8 megabyte memory card in it. And so I thought, hey, why not upgrade the memory card to say a 2 gigabyte at least? Well, the camera didn't recognize it. It only recognizes up to 8 megabytes. This is a Canon Optura XI camera, by the way. It's been around a while, but it's been a really good camera. So I wanted to make sure everything was compatible. I'm not sure if it had any compatibility issues with an 800 speed Firewire card or not. So I just went with the good old reliable. Besides, I'm not transferring feature length film, so if it's a little bit slower, whoop-de-doo, who cares? So here's what we're going to do. I want to put it in this one right here. That's interesting.
Firewire.
Now, in case I didn't mention it, always make sure your computer is on, in the full on position and everything running. Not really. Use a little bit of common sense here. I'm not a genius at this. Like I say, I'm just showing you what worked for me. Here's something else I found out on this particular computer. It's got some weird little features to it. There we go. What's weird is that some of these back here, you see it has a Phillips head screw in them. That's normal. That's normally what I would see. However, you'll see right here, this one, where I'm going to plug it in, there's a, like a pin in there. It don't take a screw. What am I going to do? What am I going to do about that? Well, look at this. That's that will hold it in. That's a weird feature of this. Before you put a card in back here, you got to squeeze these together, and it goes to the side. And you can just easily take one of these out. Don't overthink things. They made this easy if you can just kind of backwards engineer it a little bit. Here's our card. And the cool thing about it is you don't have to install any software. It's literally plug and play. Ta-da! And we're done. Put that back in. I'm just going to test it here for a second. Yeah, see, it's not going anywhere. It holds it in place without the screw. So I'm going to go ahead and put this one back up here. Now you see, it takes a Phillips head screw. I don't know why some of the slots do and some don't. That's just the way it is. So I'll go ahead and put this one back in. You might want to go ahead and take this time to clean the dust bunnies from in and around your computer. You know you got them. They can be quite dusty. They attract dust pretty good. But that's it. Let me zoom you back out so you can see my pretty face. All right. That goes back in like that. Check this out. That goes in like that too. I guess it provides support for that thing. I don't know. Anyway, I guess the next step is to turn the computer on and start transferring some video. And that's how you install your PCI Firewire card. That's too easy, wasn't it? Something's gonna go wrong. I can just feel it.
Firewire!
Down here. Installing device driver software. Click here for status. Nope. Well, device driver software installed successfully. Via OHCI compliant IEEE 1394 host controller. So see, recognize it. It's up and running. Let's see if we can transfer some video. Now, at long last, I'm getting ready to hook my camera up to my newly installed PCI card. Sweet, it recognizes it. It even says, comes up with the dialogue here, import video. Oh, sweet. It's even echoing. See, this didn't work before. Now it knows that there's a camera there. It's asking me if I want to capture a video, and it works. So if I've got it all hooked up, how am I filming the camera? Ooh. Movie magic. Update. It didn't work. When I actually clicked on the capture button to tell it to start capturing video, yeah, the program kind of froze up, dropped frames, didn't work, period. Well, what I've heard does, Dell computers particularly have problems with PCI cards sometimes. I don't know why, but what I did read was, see that there, that's the video card. I read that like the third slot down for the PCI card. Dell, for some reason, has that, I don't know, program to use an audio card. And if you try to put like a video capture card in there, it ain't going to work too good or at all. Which, without even knowing that, I would have just, you know, just troubleshooting. I would have tried plugging it into a different PCI slot anyway.
Which is what I did.
I plugged it into the last one down here. And now, you're watching this video, so it worked.
Zoom in there for you.
See, there's a video card. There's your PCI expresses. PCI, and we'll plug it in the last one, and it worked just fine. So if yours don't work, just try a different slot. That's the first thing you do anyway. And that's the end of this video. Or is it?
sheets in the crib, ma.
Drop it right up. Drop it right up. Pop it right up.
When the pigs try to get at you.
Pop it right up. Pop it right up. Pop it right up.
And if a get an attitude.
Pop it right up. Pop it right up. Pop it right up.
I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm the best because I got it going on.
Firewire.
And in case y'all are interested, here's my scary mask.